Pope Benedict XVI spent 8 years as a successor of the late John Paul II, but he is now the first pope in nearly 600 years to resign as leader of the Roman Catholic Church. The entire world focused on the pontiff's last day at the Vatican, in which he delivered his final speech thanking everyone for their support and pledging unconditional reverence and obedience to his successor. People also watched as the 85-year-old was whisked away by helicopter to begin his journey into retirement, where he will be known as Pope Emeritus. Another journey also begins to elect a new pope. Father Adrian Castobel, Chancellor of the Archdiocese of Gagna, explains to PNC how this process works.
In the Vatican, the cardinals that are eligible to vote will be participating in what's called the conclave, where they will meet in the Vatican, and it will be a process of electing a successor.
So how do the cardinals pick a successor?
There are 115 some cardinals that will be participating in the conclave. Primarily, it is primarily a spiritual experience for them. It's also an experience of communion for them. And they will perhaps deliberate, and they will perhaps get to know each other. And then there'll be moments defined in their ruling, the moments in which they will be taking their votes.
Father Cristobal is neither sure how soon it will take for votes to be cast, nor does he know of any potential candidates that could replace Pope Benedict. Meanwhile, he says day-to-day administrative tasks at the Vatican remain at the standstill, and masses on Guam will have slight changes.
The changes will be, for example, in the recitation of the Eucharistic prayer. Okay. In the Mass, in the Eucharistic prayer, we mention the Pope's name. For the time being, that from Friday, 5 o'clock in the morning on, until the election of a new pope, that phrase referring to the pope in the Eucharistic prayer will be omitted.
The chancellor adds this is the perfect moment for the island's faithful to pray for the cardinals to elect a man of faith, and to also pray for Pope Benedict. Despite his short time as pope, Father Cristobal still believes Benedict is a man of humility, who did what was best for the Roman Catholic Church.
He's also a man of truth, I believe. A man of truth who realizes his limitations and realizes that what's more important really is the church, you know, and he feels that now is the time for him to step down. And I'm sure he did this with a lot of prayer.
Josh Dikenko, PNC News.